From past 1 week, that CBI and CBI, West CBI row has taken the news headlines by storm. And we have with us Mr. Shantonu Sen, who is the former Joint Director of CBI. Sir, first of all, thank you for giving your time. Sir, first of all, I would like to know your thoughts about this controversy going on related to CBI.
It's not really a controversy. CBI is an anti-corruption agency, and now corruption has been reported in the upper ranks of the CBI, and the men who have made the charges are themselves senior CBI officers. It is the duty of every CBI officer to investigate corruption, and if he finds corruption among his colleagues, he has to report it to the special unit in the CBI, which watches the officer and then comes. CBI from the very beginning has been very alert about corruption in its own department, and this corruption has now been reported against the director and the special director by people of this rank.
How you see Supreme Court role playing in that overall, that CBI role?
Supreme Court, by virtue of its Chief Justice, has a part in appointing the director CBI. Supreme Court investigates, Supreme Court takes up for trial all cases which come up in appeal to the Supreme Court after they are investigated by the CBI. Supreme Court does not monitor the CBI. So Supreme Court, I don't see any role of Supreme Court in monitoring the CBI. That role is of the CVC under the Delhi Special Police Establishment Act. It is the Central Vigilance Commission which monitors the anti-corruption wing of the CBI. And this is the anti-corruption wing of the CBI working, and the CVC will monitor it. Supreme Court is supreme body of this country, and any matter relating to any department can go to the Supreme Court. But Supreme Court has no role in monitoring the CBI.
And sir, many political parties like Congress is alleging that BJP is hampering the image of the independent institutions like CBI, Election Commission. What do you have to say about that?
Yes, politicians, both political parties have been saying this against each other for a long time. But the fact is, in CBI, it is the Congress party which has been in governance for the longest time. And the Congress party is responsible for the governance of the CBI for the longest time. And the Congress party has erred in maintaining the CBI, though it was the great Home Minister of the country, Mr. Lal Bahadur Shastri, who really founded the CBI. And he saw a CBI as an institution where there will be CBI officers directly recruited in the CBI to learn the art of detectiving and then being master detectives of the organization. And that is why he started direct recruitment of CBI officers through the Union Public Service Commission in 1963 itself. I am in the first batch of those officers. We learned policing by going to Mount Abu Police Training Academy, and then we went to various states. I went to Maharashtra to learn the art of policing. And then I spent 2 years learning the art of investigation within the CBI. And then only I started working. And I learned how to investigate, which means how to search, interrogate, register cases, send cases to court, send them for trial, watch them over trial. This was the work I did. And thereafter, there were every year recruitment in the CBI of direct recruits who learned this work, and that went on every year till 1973. And then there was some gap. But subsequently, the future directors of CBI who had no working in the CBI, like Mr. Raghavan, Mr. Vijay Rama Rao, and Mr. Vijay Karan, they had no knowledge of CBI functioning, and they and Mr. Raghavan found that the earlier directors also stopped the recruitment and then completely eliminated recruitment of direct officers. Result is the inside investigating officers of our nature and our types are no longer in the CBI. Historically, the CBI's best period is from 1970 to 1990, when we were officers were recruited every year and we were investigating. We were naam roshan kar rahe the hum log CBI ka. But once these officers were stopped recruiting and you had only officers on deputation and no state sends its best officers to the CBI, we had no investigating officer of real caliber as far as I can see. And we had detectives, we have directors who were outside the CBI. People like Mr. Raghavan, Mr. Vijayakaran, Mr. Vijayarama Rao, and now Mr. Verma. They had no institutional memory because they were never been in the institution. If you don't have an institutional memory, how can you head the institution? Every state has a DJP who has worked in that state. But CBI, where the principle was that if you want to go up in the CBI, you should work as SP, DIG, and earlier directors were like that. They'd all worked in the CBI. People like Mr. Katre, Mr. Shekhar, Mr. S.K. Datta, Mr. D. Sen, Mr. John Lobo. They were great directors. They had worked in the CBI from the very beginning and as SP rank, and they rose to that highest position. So they had institutional memory. They knew how to run the CBI. If you come directly into CBI like Mr. Ramdev Singh came, Mr. Vijayakaran came, Mr. Vijayarama Rao came, Mr. Raghavan came, and now Mr. Sharma has come, Mr. Anil Sinha came. They had no institutional memory. So CBI and the direct recruitment in the CBI also stopped from 2000. So there were no master detectives. So ye to hona hi tha.
So people in India regard CBI very high.
That is because they did wonderful work from 1970 to now. You see, it was our record. It is the past record which made CBI important. I have heard High Court judge say, I respect the CBI finding as much as I respect the Supreme Court finding. That was our reputation. But that was the past made up of great directors who had worked in CBI in all ranks. We had old officers in the CBI, I remember them, Sri Krishan Lal, Gurdas Mal, R.S. Darbari. They were old CBI insiders. They did so good work, Ramendra Singh, Mr. Josaram. We learned from them. They were CBI officers. And they taught us how to investigate. Now such officers are not there. There are no insiders in the CBI. CBI is largely made of deputationists who have no experience of training. And these deputationists are from which? ITBP, BSF, CRPF, Railway Protection Force. So the CBI's name grew because of the outstanding officers who were CBI insiders. And then there was recruitment. Officers like Mr. K. Madhavan, Mr. R.M. Singh, Mr. A.W. Digwekar, Mr. R.N. Kaur, Mr. A.K. Suri, profound R.D.A. Harishchandra Singh. They were all insiders, brilliant officers, worked hard. They knew how investigation was. I'm one of them. Why have you come to me? Why have you not gone for an interview to somebody else? Because I worked in the CBI. I did very important case in the CBI. My book, CBI Insider Speaks, or the other book, Foul Play, explains these investigations. I can talk on the CBI. I have an institutional memory of the CBI. Now you post people who have no knowledge of the CBI. The CBI will be in, CBI will be, Mr. Asthana was a CBI officer, but he was not allowed to function properly, I think.
Cases like this, which is happening in CBI, do you think it is hampering the image of the CBI? Do you think it can be get better in coming years? And what can be the roadmap to achieve that?
Roadmap is what was being done in the 60s. After all, why did the CBI get this achievement? Because from 60s onwards, CBI had insiders who knew how to investigate, and CBI had bosses who had worked in the CBI. Replicate that, have insiders, recruit good officers, train them as detectives, and promote those officers from the Indian Police Service or any other service who have worked in the CBI as SP, DIG, joined there. Only give them the rank. Don't bring somebody who has no institutional memory of the CBI, who has never worked in the CBI as director. If you do that, probably in 5-6 years, CBI will regain its glory. If you continue this way, have no direct officers in the CBI, have deputations from BSF, CRPF, ITPB, RPF to work as investigators, and appoint people in high position who have never worked in the CBI, CBI's reputation will become even worse.
From your vast experience, I would like to know that an institution like CBI can be fully controlled by a government.
CBI has never been controlled by government. CBI has always been controlled by the law of the land. We may be appointed by the government, but we work under the law. So if you allow the law to control you, then there is no problem. Yes, posting transfers will be the government, because CBI is a police department. But officers within the CBI should have only one master, and that is the law. And from 1960 to 1992, that was the position. The law, there was a dip, I agree, in the emergency, and in 1980 when Mrs. Gandhi came back, very corrupt officers were chosen to drop all the investigations against Mrs. Gandhi's team. They suffered. That was temporary 2 years dip. But when Rajiv Gandhi became the Prime Minister, he brought the best men as director and the additional director, Mr. Kasari and Mr. Nair. Mr. Rajiv Gandhi restored the position. And then there was, I think, Mr. Shekhar, Mr. A.P. Mukherjee, Mr. S.K. Datta. They were all insiders. They had worked in the CBI. So a good Prime Minister like Rajiv Gandhi restored the image. Mrs. Gandhi was a very good Prime Minister earlier days, but when she came back in 1990, she was under the control of Sanjay Gandhi. So he posted somebody who knew no experience of CBI and got them to do some funny business. But that was just 1 year, 2 year dip. But after 98, with Vijay Rama Rao as Director of CBI, who helped Narasimha Rao's son to escape investigation in the urea scam, who transferred the joint director, Mr. R.M. Singh, because he was going to search Prabhakar Rao's house, who did not allow him. That was the beginning of the downfall. Then Raghavan came. He said, let us get rid of direct recruits. He stopped recruitment. He did very good work in the Gujarat case, where he's rewarded today. At the age of 80, he's High Commissioner in Cyprus. He loved a foreign posting. He's got it. If you have such people who have illusions, who are looking for post-retirement jobs, yehi hoga.
Sir, final question. If I talk about the differences of CBI working under Congress government and BJP government, particularly some points you want to highlight, what were the differences?
See, the CBI has existed as a special police establishment from 1943. And after 1963, it is the Central Bureau of Investigation. So the Congress government has been there from 1947, right up to virtually 1998, yes. So, from 1950 to 1990, CBI's image was very good. CBI had insiders in the CBI. They were recruits from other police, but Sri Krishan Lal, his team, there are a number of others, Jyotaram, Ramendra Singh, who were insiders. They did very good work. CBI's reputation was built as SPE, then as Central Bureau of Investigation. Lal Bahadur Shastri, Murarji Desai, Mrs. Gandhi, CBI's image was very good. Emergency, Mrs. Gandhi failed, CBI was misused by his son, Sanjay Gandhi. 1980 also CBI was misused, but very limitedly, because CBI had many people who would refuse to bend. But that was a brief period. Congress government again came in Narasimha Rao's government. That was the beginning. Narasimha Rao got the wrong man as director. He had to save his son in the urea scam. He had to save his principal secretary, his own cabinet secretary. So he got a director who would listen to him. It is not I who is calling him the poodle of CBI, poodle of Narasimha Rao. Mr. Veer Sanghvi made this comment that Vijayarama Rao is the poodle of Narasimha Rao. Under his maligned leadership, CBI has gone down. That was Veer Sanghvi's statement. And since then, downfall. Raghavan and other directors, three directors now of CBI are facing criminal investigation. Was CBI ke andar ke hi the, but they had done no work in CBI of any merit. Good officers like M.L. Sharma, R.K. Datta, who were CBI officers, they were not promoted. M.L. Sharma's promotion was snatched away at the last moment. And one Ashwani Kumar was made director. His only good work was that he had constructed the house of Vadras in Himachal Pradesh. That was his qualification. And a few months experience in the CBI. Later on he was made governor. So which government are you talking about? BJP government has just come now. If CBI's downfall, good work was done by the Congress government. Very good work, 50 to 90. Great prime ministers. We had freedom fighters, great leaders. The downfall started with Mr. Narasimha Rao. And since then it has been downfall. Vajpayee's government also, Raghavan posting, downfall. And then again, Manmohan Rai's, Manmohan Singh's government. They have two directors who are under criminal investigation. M.L. Sharma was tipped to be director. Last moment, Priyanka wanted the one who built his house to be made director, and he was made director. So what are you talking about? Don't compare. Both governments after 1998 are responsible for the downfall of CBI. But under the great Congress prime ministers, great, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Mr. Lal Bahadur Shastri, Mrs. Indira Gandhi, during her best period, Morarji Desai, Rajiv Gandhi, CBI was a great organization. CBI had done great work.
Well, indeed. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for talking 10 years.
The most frank thing.
Right, sir.